We put them on a table. Two white and two brown dolls, exactly the same in every respect except color. We put no clothes on them except a diaper, and we asked the children a number of very simple questions. Show me the white doll. Show me the colored doll. We then asked them preference questions, such as, show me the doll you'd like to play with. Show me or give me the doll that's a nice doll. Show me the doll that's a bad doll. And we found that the majority of black children at that time did in fact ascribe the positive characteristics to the white doll and the negative characteristics to the brown doll. I then asked the question, now show me the doll that's like you. Some of those children looked at me as if I were the devil himself for putting them in that predicament. It was the beginning of psychologists' understanding of the terrible damage that's done to human beings by racial rejection.
And that sent a shockwave, I think, through the black community, understanding very thoroughly that little black girls did not have self-esteem, did not think of themselves as beautiful, and would prefer to have a white doll.
And the outcome of that test, many of the judges on the Supreme Court in the Brown versus Board of Education decision said it was the piece of evidence that pushed them over. Not the statistics, not the unequal supplies going to the schools, not the slipshod construction of the schools. None of that was as convincing as what they got from the Clark test. So as a result of that, we got the Supreme Court decision in Brown versus Board of Education that desegregates the school.